Let's meet the lineup for your visitors, Arsenal Detroit. Number 24, Owen Baker. Number 97, Tommy Marvin. Number 71, Michael Messick. Number 8, Joseph Olmstead. Number 7, Jack O'Hennessy. Number 25, Jack Sexsmith. Number 18, Rutger McGarty. And the goaltender, number 1, Trent Borshek. Head coach of Arsenal Detroit, Jeff Marvin. Time now to meet our home team, the Mississauga Rattlers Grey. Number 16, Mick Thompson. Number 88, Number 90, Connor Gauthier. Number 22, Liam Boswell. Number 44, Sean Williams. Number 14, Rio Takanu. Number 93, Ryan Struthers. Number 6, Spencer Hughes. And the goaltender for the Rattlers Grey, number 15, those are your two teams. Let's lace them up and get her going. The Squirt Platinum Championship coming up right now at the 2017 NARCH Finals. We'll be right back. fans, let's make some noise. It's the Squirt Platinum Championship Game. You're gonna have to get louder next time.
All right, we are here live from the Hershey Center. Thanks for joining on the 2017 NARCH live stream. This is Squirt Platinum action between the Rattlers Gray, who are in the gray jerseys, against the Arsenal Detroit, who are in the white. They have the puck with Olmstead. Olmstead walking up, trying to get one off in on the goaltender. The goaltender, Owen Ellis, for the Rattlers Gray. His counterpart at the other side is Trent Borchek. And we're gonna have our first penalty of the hockey game. It's gonna be a hooking call called against the Rattlers Gray. And it looks like it's gonna go against Panofimis, number 88. So the Arsenal Detroit will go on the power play here for the first time, a 90-second power play. Lucky enough to be joined by longtime NARCH stalwart, Alex Morrison. And Alex, thanks for joining up. I knew you wouldn't miss this one for sure, this Squirt Platinum Championship.
No, this is going to be a great game here. Two very talented teams, and this is the future of roller hockey right here in front of you.
Yeah, like we say in these divisions, you can watch the future today. Here's a chance now for the Arsenal shot right on, and Ellis makes the save. The Rattlers trying to clear it up the floor, and they do. Racing with it is Thompson. Thompson going in shorthanded. Thompson makes a move, shot! And Borchek makes the save there. The other direction come the Arsenal again, still trying to set things up now. Is Messick. Messick had it lost. The puck is right in the zone. Now another chance now for Thompson. Thompson's got help with him. Cruising up into the play was Gauthier. Tried to feed it across, couldn't make the connection. 30 seconds, and they really have not been able to get anything going on the power play, Alex.
No, Ryan Struthers here at defense in the white helmet, number 93 for the Rattlers Gray, had an incredible reach. Was able to poke the puck out of the way on a great scoring opportunity.
All right, now Gauthier with the puck, working wide, trying to step in into the slot, smacks one towards the net. 10 seconds remaining here in the man advantage. Almost made the connection off the bank pass on the boards. Nice slap away at the puck lane, keep away from the Arsenal. And the penalty has expired, so they successfully kill off that initial power play. Good job by the penalty killers. And now Fimis out of the box walking in. Here's a chance right out front on the doorstep. And just missing was Fimis. And Fimis trying to bank it into the corner. He works it to his teammate Gauthier. Gauthier and Fimis really buzzing out there in the rink. Here comes the Arsenal. They're trying to get two on one the other way. Walking into the backhand, shovels it wide of the net. Not the best of decisions there for Owen Baker. Trying to settle the puck down is Fimis. Fimis in front, and Thompson didn't find anyone home. Long pass up ahead. Oh, if that would have been a good pass, that would have been a breakaway. Now they still have a chance. Racing back, and oh, he slams on the brakes. Odd decision there by the Arsenal's number 8, Olmstead. Just don't know if maybe he didn't feel it or perhaps pulled up a little bit late.
No, Jeremy, I think he didn't feel that he had enough room. He thought someone was a little closer than they were.
There's a shot right in on Borchek, who makes another save. Still no score here in a hockey game. We've had some great finals the past couple days. A couple of 1-0 finishes yesterday. Earlier in the Squirt Gold Championship game, it was Bell Tire out of Detroit, so Arsenal Detroit looking to add on. Now here's a chance the other direction, shot right on Borchek, save, rebound, scores! The Rattlers on the board, that's Gauthier up ahead of the pack, and Gauthier jams in the rebound on the breakaway to put his Rattlers great team on top, 1-0.
Looks like Arsenal fell asleep a little bit there on defense. Gauthier sitting cherry-picking back behind the defense. And that long stretch pass right through two defenders of Arsenal. Shot and a rebound by the guy all alone in front.
Now, Alex, last game there was Gavin Cherry playing for the Bell Tire team. There's a shot for Borchek save. He'll hold on. Now, is Cherry capable of cherry picking?
Nice play on words. That poor kid is going to have to hear that for the rest of his hockey career. And it's great of you to stir the pot there with that, Jeremy.
He had a great game in that one. His team taking home a gold medal. Arsenal try. Oh, nice play off the draw. They bank it up ahead. Here comes a 2-on-1 now for the Arsenal. They feed it across. Oh, couldn't get the handle right away if he could have got the shot off quickly. Owen Baker may have had a chance to bury that home.
One big difference here, Jeremy, is the defense, the breakdowns that you see here at the squirt level, even though this is platinum, they happen quite often as compared to the older divisions.
It's probably a little bit of the undisciplined play. The official blows the whistle. He lost sight of the puck. That, of course, is longtime Narch official Corey Borden. And Alex, you know what kind of game you're going to get with Corey Borden out on the floor. It's going to be clean, it's going to be concise, and it's going to be consistent.
It sure is. I lost sight of the puck as well, and that is the job of the referee in that case, to blow the whistle. The goalie didn't know where it was. It was under his pads for a minute. He actually spun around, and that's what kicked the puck loose. So I actually agree with him on this whistle.
There's a move in front. Gauthier had it gobbled up by Borochek. Corey Borden, a success story in itself, and the fact that he started off as a mere scorekeeper here in the Narch circuit and worked his way up to high-level official.
Yeah, I don't know that I'd ever use the term mere when talking about our scorekeepers, because they do one heck of a job and are a big part of our staff here.
Thanks to all of our scorekeeping staff that have been working hard here during the 2017 Narch Finals. They're responsible for all that pumped-up music that you hear in the arena. Now Thompson back the other way, making a nice move. Thompson cruising right in. Almost was able to get that on the stick, but a good lift at the last second by the Arsenal. And they transition on offense, coming through the slot. Nothing there. He was waiting for some help. It never came. Now Gauthier outlets the puck to Thompson. This Rattlers team really transitions from defense to offense quickly.
Yeah, Thompson's been skating up and down the floor, back checking, and then leading the offense as well.
Gauthier trying to bang the puck away. It goes in. A save made there by Ellis. Now Gauthier goes up to Thompson again. He couldn't find the handle on it. Chipped off the boards, providing support for the Rattlers with number 6, Spencer Hughes. Turns it over. Now the Arsenal, other direction. Oh, he was right in the slot. Passing it. There's another chance right there for the Arsenal. Messick was there on the back door. Now here comes Fimis. Fimis racing up the floor, working 1-on-2. Toe dragging in, shooting, scoring. What a rip there by Pano Fimis as he goes 1-on-1. Toe drags the puck. Let's watch it right here again, Alex, up on the big screen. Fimis coming right down, toe dragging and firing all in one smooth motion. And the Rattlers on top 2-0.
Yeah, interesting defensive decision there by Arsenal, just kind of sitting back and letting him come at him rather than stepping into him and getting the stick in the way.
Now a chance back the other direction. Thomas feeding in front. Fimis was biting for goal number 2 there. Saved by Borochek. Now the Arsenal smarting just a bit, trailing this hockey game 2-0. They're trying to get back into things. There's a long shot, and Owen Ellis pops that one up into the back of the net.
Yeah, you had Mick Thompson dive in front of that slap shot, take a tumble. Looked like hit down there pretty hard, but he popped right back up and got into the play. But, you know, I see him going over to the bench a little gingerly, and he'll get a well-deserved rest there.
So a shot by Fimis goes off the goaltender and out of play. So we'll resume action deep inside the Arsenal Detroit end zone. Puck controlled by the Rattlers. They have it cycling through the center of the rink.
Yeah, you see the Rattlers here content to stay high. They don't have anyone picking down low, and they're hoping to find a hole in the Arsenal defense.
They get it down low, now walking right in, feeding it across, man's wide open, and scoring once again. This time the feed goes to Spencer Hughes. I believe that was Gauthier that set him up on the backside. Let's watch here. Gauthier in the corner makes a move, draws the defender, and Hughes is wide open. Nothing that Borochek can do there. His team now trails it 3-0.
Just as I spoke of defensive breakdowns, another one happens there. Hughes coming from up high, sneaking down low, right behind a defender. No one picked him up, and that's a pretty easy shot. He's the youngest player on the floor by a year. He's the only 05 out here. Everyone else is 04s, and he was able to put the puck in the back of the net.
Gote with the shot. That's what you bring to the table, Alex. All those little tidbits. How does one store all that vast array of knowledge?
You know, a lot of experience, Jeremy. A lot of experience.
Now the Arsenal still looking for their first shot of the hockey game, or first goal of the hockey game. Ellis makes the save there. They swing it back up top to the point. Rattlers providing pressure. Gote came out high. Now a chance right there in the slot. Ellis fights it away. Hops on it quickly for the whistle. And he hangs on. 3-0 Rattlers on top. 4:28 remaining here in the period.
Yeah, Ellis for the Rattlers has had a little bit of a hard time seeing the puck and holding on to it. The Arsenal, as long as they can keep some offensive pressure on, I can see them sneaking one past him pretty soon.
Well, I wonder if that has anything to do with our introductions where one of those strobe lights went just a bit haywire and affected some of the players down there on the floor. I knew one of the coaches actually had to go to the restroom due to the strobe light, so let's keep an eye on things the rest of the hockey game.
Absolutely, Jeremy.
Back the other direction. Here comes Fimis. Fimis makes a move, scores as he walks right around the defense and draws the goal. Who couldn't make Fimis, let's take a look at it. Just the speed of Fimis right around the goalie. Voracek gambled and lost. His pair of nines were beaten by AK. And the goal there, Fimis makes it a 4-0 hockey league, or 4-0 hockey lead. And I tell you what, oh, do we have a timeout? Yes, Arsenal, I was going to say, you may want to take a timeout here. They're just shell-shocked just a bit here.
Yeah, another. This is defense once again, letting them use that speed and not getting their body in front of them. Both, you saw both defenders there reaching out with their sticks rather than moving their body into the skating lane, preventing him from getting to that great spot in front of the net. And just like that, it's 4-0. And this is the story of Mississauga converting on all of their chances and Arsenal not finding a way to put the puck in the back of the net on their chances. This game is not as lopsided as the score says, so this is a great timeout by Arsenal. If they can put this together and score a goal before the end of the half, 4-1, I think we have one heck of a second half coming up.
So let's see how the Arsenal respond after the timeout. Face off at the center of the rink.
We're waiting here on the Arsenal goalie. He's pretty dejected here, but if he can make a few saves to end this half, his team might be able to come back here.
Now there's a shot by the Arsenal that goes just wide of the net. Now a chance for the Rattlers. Gray Thompson shot handled by Voracek, and Voracek hangs on for the whistle there.
Yeah, Trent just trying to make sure he gets to feel that plastic up against him. It's a nice save coming off of a timeout. He holds on to it. Now hopefully his team gets a faceoff win and can take the puck down the other way.
The faceoff will be down in the Arsenal zone. 3:50 left to go here in a first period that's been dominated by the Rattlers thus far. Arsenal still trying to go, and that's just been the type of game it's been. The player falls down before he can get across the red line. Now they look back to the far side, and there's a shot that Owen Ellis makes the save. Alex, I see you saw something down in the corner.
Yeah, I was actually pointing just then as you saw Jack Hannison sneak behind the defense, just like the Rattlers were doing to Arsenal. Arsenal now played a little of that game with the Rattlers, and he almost got a stick on it, tipping it, but Ellis was able to hold on.
Well, I'm guessing the Arsenal are going to have to take just a few more chances. And there's,
yeah.
Let's see what happens. No goal. They're going to say a kick.
Yeah, of bad place, bad time. He had a nice tic-tac-toe going on. Not able to get a stick on it. He did turn his skate, and it goes directly into the net. But we do have a conversation out here with the officials.
Well, let's see. This one is not over yet. Will they change the call here? Both officials, and this is what you want out of these two officials, to converge and discuss and see if one had a better look. They're going to call it a goal, Alex. Unbelievable.
That is unbelievable. I'm not sure what the conversation was there. They did, the puck did go off his foot. The question at this point is, did he turn and intentionally direct it in? Does not have to be a distinct kicking motion.
Can we get one more replay? Can we get one more replay and kind of look at this again? Here's the play. Gauthier loses it. The little tic-tac-toe.
It just looked to me live, and you couldn't really see it on the replay. It looked like he did angle his skate. So I thought the initial call was correct, but whatever conversation that happened out there with the two officials, they determined that it was not intentional and just banked off of the player. And if that's the case, then that would be a good goal.
That is a good goal. So with that, now it is a 4-1 hockey game. And Gauthier walking right in. And again, we saw it earlier in the hockey game. Gauthier takes a shot. Voracek makes the save. But Gauthier there to slam dunk home the rebound.
Yeah, big juicy rebound there. You'll see it here. Gauthier on the left side. Defenseman, rather than stepping up into him, makes a swipe at the puck and then doesn't pick up the man. So you have him wide open there. You have Trent from Arsenal, the goaltender, leaving that juicy rebound there. And Gauthier knows what to do with that.
So 3 minutes remaining here, and it's back to a four-goal lead. Gauthier looking for more. Gauthier walking in, had an angle and actually went a little bit wider on the defender, and his centering pass is intercepted. Back come the Arsenal. Arsenal, nice move right in the slot. A save there by Ellis, cruising in for the Arsenal. It was Michael Messier. Messier with that one. Now they come back the other direction. Do the Rattlers. Is this Struthers? Struthers fed it across, didn't get the return pass, and now they bang away at it deep in the Arsenal end.
Arsenal need to put some pressure on here. 2:15 to go in this first half, and they have three men skating into the offensive zone.
There's a long shot. It was hard, but wide.
Yeah, that's Owen Baker. Wishes he could have that back. That ends up being a turnover and gives the Rattlers the puck going and trying to score some more.
Turn the puck back over to the Rattlers. The Arsenal, nice give and go, but it was on the backhand of the Arsenal player who couldn't handle it there. Under 2 minutes left, 1:48 left to go here in period number one. Long pass up ahead to Gauthier. Gauthier has been a force here in the hockey game into the top of the circle. Working, shooting, scoring. Gauthier is on fire. He is abusing the defenders and really on the goaltender.
Yeah, this is just another case. This is not Voracek's fault in any way whatsoever. This has the defense just completely confuzzled, as my 10-year-old daughter would say. They don't know how to handle this attack. So rather than stepping up, once again, he reaches out with a stick. It doesn't work out, and you have a great shot from the slot.
1:35 left to go here.
We'll see if the Rattlers slow it down a little bit or if they keep the foot on the gas pedal. Arsenal, though, with a little bit of pressure back the other way, but there's a turnover.
Turnover back the other way to Thompson. Thompson cruising in to the slot. Oh, fed it down low. He was trying to get it to his teammate down there. As entering the play was Sean Williams. Trying to go wide on Finnis. Ends up all the way back to the point for the Arsenal. They trail the hockey game 6-1 here. This is our Squirt Platinum Championship game. Coming up after this, Alex, we go into the Bantam Division, and we'll have Gold and Platinum Championship games there. So four straight championship games. A heck of a day here on the arena rink at the Hershey Center.
A lot of strobe light action, a lot of announcements happening, and a great time by all. Great shot there, but a save by Ellis. We will have the Platinum Final first and then followed by the Gold Final.
Yeah, let's hope we can keep the seizures down during those strobe lights. Now Thompson cruising in. Thompson shot steered aside by Voracek. Arsenal trying to get one more look at it here as the period concludes. And Ellis again makes a save. Ellis just smacks it out right to the Arsenal. And oh, he lucked up there, but it still is right there on the side of the net. Not sure what Ellis was thinking there as Thompson takes it. Sends it back to the middle, dangerous pass, but the horn will sound. That will do it for our first period of action with your score. The Rattlers on top, 6-1. So the Arsenal trailing this hockey game as we've entered the second period of action. Arsenal still trying to look and almost turned it over. That would have been a break the other direction. There's a long shot, goes right off the post. Now the play to the Arsenal. Circling behind the net, feeding it right out front. And unbelievable, did Ellis get a piece of that? He did. And now he makes a save. Can we get a replay on that save right in front of the net? That is player all alone. And the save by Ellis. Wow. So a 5-goal lead for the Rattlers, Gray. And Owen Ellis just made one heck of a save. Still trying to get something going. They can't. Long out let pass up ahead. Fimis. Fimis tried to feed it over to his teammate who was coming into the play. Williams. Now the Arsenal back the other direction. Trying to get something going here was Tommy Marvin. Marvin couldn't get rolling. Now the Rattlers Gray take control of the puck once again. Thompson swings it back to Fimis. Trying to toe drag it through the middle and unable to do so. Now the Rattlers with Fimis have it the other direction. Chance out front. And that one's knocked away. Man for the Arsenal all alone. Shooting, scoring up over the goaltender Ellis. The Arsenal trying to work their on the board. You can see it. A nice pass down low and then a great move to go over the goaltender. That was number 97 for the Arsenal, Tommy Marvin. Chance for the Arsenal as he works it way. And a quick shot there by the Arsenal, and that one's in the back of the net. Look at the nifty play there. So unfortunately, don't have that number on my roster, so I can't tell you who scored it, but it was a beautiful goal nonetheless. Cuts the lead in half. It's now 6-3. Shot goes in on Voracek, and Voracek makes the save there. Back the other direction for the Arsenal. Messick Messick's pass attempt. Send it back out in front. Gauthier trying to spin away. He maintains possession of the puck. Now he's banged into the boards. He's still battled away. Now the Arsenal try to clear. Comes up the boards. Intercepted by the Rattlers. Gauthier with it. Gauthier in all alone. Gauthier shot. Rebound. No. Almost pulled it off for a third time. The shot, save, rebound, goal for Gauthier. Arsenal with the long centering pass. Oh, and almost able to tip that in out of the air. There's a shot that goes up high off the glass. There's a play right in front of the Arsenal net. Arsenal break back the other direction with it. Long shot, scores, and the Arsenal! All right. The four. I want to say that that's the player whose number I don't have, unfortunately. But a big, hard shot by him, and now it's 6-4. Thompson trying to make the move through. There's a shot, and Finnis's shot saved there by Borochek. Pass over, doesn't find the mark, and Fimis takes it. Here's a long shot that goes wider than that. Play goes behind. Now it's taken back by the Rattlers, working it up the floor. 5:25 left to go here. There's a shot in. Borochek with the save. It laid there in front, and it was off the stick of Williams. Now Thompson takes it back to Fimis, who sends it up the floor as he carries. Back over to Thompson. That shot goes in, and it'll be held by Borochek. Comes back the other direction. The Arsenal player hit the skids and falls down. Now they have the puck. Messick. Now on the boards. There is a shot, and that one goes off of Ellis into the corner. Messick feeds it in front. Another look. Shot scores. It's now 6-5. Do you believe in miracles? The rebound there, it's unfortunate, but fortunate. It's the player whose number we don't have. on the roster. His number is in the 40s. Let me see if I can maybe deduce who that player is. He's having a whale of a hockey game. Let me see, I see 97. That's Marvin and 24 Baker out there. 7 is O'Hanigan. Who else do we have out there? There's Fimis back up the floor now for the Rattlers. He's getting a little hairy now for the Rattlers. Big save by Bororchak. He pedals that one to the corner. Arsenal player hits the deck. That was number 8, Olmstead. Is it Jack O'Hanigan, number 7? Or maybe Jack Sexsmith, 25? Not sure who the player is that have scored and been the catalyst for this big Arsenal-Detroit comeback. Now they send it up ahead to Gauthier. Gauthier trying to make a move. Oh, and a high stick right to Gauthier's face mask. And we're going to have a penalty coming up to the Arsenal's number 24, Owen Baker. Comes all the way back up top to Thompson. His team on the power play and with the lead. Fed across. Blim is trying to get it on the backside to Gauthier. Now a chance for the Arsenal if they can get possession of the puck. Comes right down into the center. They feed it down low. Didn't find the mark. There's 35 seconds remaining in this one. Closing in on 2 minutes to 1-goal hockey game. 4 straight goals by the Arsenal after trailing 6-1 has put them back in the mix. Here's a chance right out in front. Gauthier tries to swing it home. Lost it. 10 seconds remain in the power play now. The Arsenal trying to fight this one off. There's a pass in front. Thompson rifles one wide of the net. Puck is over in the corner. Puck goes wide of the net. Both teams back at full strength. 1:08 left to go here in this one. The Arsenal with the puck will keep an eye on Bororchak. Pass up the floor, taken by the Arsenal now. Here comes the Arsenal back the other direction, trying to make a move. It's poked away. They have a man on the back door. Oh, and it just hopped over a stick. Goalie still. Oh, there's another centering chance. There's a player down in the corner for the Arsenal. Not sure what happened. He's down. Here's Gauthier the other way. Feeds in front. Fimis, big save by Rorschach. Now the Arsenal have a chance. Oh, a player for the Arsenal lost his stick. Now Gauthier trying to make the move. Gauthier gets free. Gauthier shot. Oh, and that one goes wider than that. 20 seconds left. Goaltender still in between the pipes. Can they get him off? They try to go up the boards. Thompson intercepts. Now a play back the other direction. Here's a chance, one last try, and that will do it. Fimis back to Gauthier as the clock runs out. And that is over. No goal over there. And the final score, the Rattlers Gray hold on to win this one by a final score of 6-5. Stick around, our award ceremony coming up here on the floor at the 2017 NARCH Finals.
Our exciting champion once again for the Arsenal Detroit Mississauga Rattlers Gray. Our third place team is the Roadrunners, if the Roadrunners would like to make their way out onto the floor. When you hear your name, please come up to accept your award. Tegan Maleski. Dario Cicina. Christian Pietromonaco. Sammy Phillips. Kevin Bradley. Sebastian Elrod. Brady Baser. Riley Goodwin. Primo Baldessar. Head coach, Anthony Violante. Congratulations to all of our third place winners here, the Detroit Roadrunners in the Squared Platinum Division. Next up, we have our silver medals to the Arsenal Detroit. Owen Baker. Trent Borochik. Tommy Marvin. Michael Messick. Joseph Olmsted. Jack Hannigan. Jack Sexsmith. Michael Messick. Rutger McGordy. Head coach, Jeff Martin. Congratulations to all the players on the Arsenal Detroit. Time now to hand out our gold medals to the Mississauga Rattlers Gray. Mick Thompson. Hanno Finnis. Cutter Gauthier. Liam Boswell. Sean Williams. Rio Takano.
Struthers. Spencer Hughes. Goaltender Owen Ellis. Head coach Phil Nolan. Assistant coach Darren Thompson. Congratulations to all the members of the Mississauga Rattlers, Greg. In our Squirt Platinum division, we have two individual awards. Our first award is for our high score in the division. Our high score finished with 16 goals and 9 assists, a 4.16 points per game average. From the Rattlers grade, number 90, Cutter Gauthier. Our top goaltender in the division faced 119 shots and made 97 saves, an 8.15 save percentage. From the Arsenal Detroit, Trent Borowczyk. Congratulations to both of our individual award winners. And finally, if we can have the Rattlers out to accept the trophy as the 2017 NARCH Final Squirt Platinum Champions. Congratulations to the Rattlers.